Did you know that Adobe has a portfolio builder that you can utilize to make your very own graphic design portfolio? What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics. And today we're going to take a look at the awesome portfolio builder by Adobe. Now, just a quick disclaimer, hashtag not sponsored, because I am not sponsored by Adobe or anyone in today's video. I just find this portfolio builder really interesting and really helpful, so do follow along and see if you agree with me. Adobe has created an awesome piece of software to create your portfolio. Now, Adobe Portfolio is completely free for those of you who have a Creative Cloud subscription. Now, that can just be a single application or multiple apps, but if you pay a monthly fee for Creative Cloud, then you can use Adobe Portfolio. Now, you simply need to sign into your Creative Cloud account in the top right menu here. But before we get into the portfolio creation side of things, let's quickly check out an example of somebody who has used Adobe Portfolio. Now, I was having a browse over these examples earlier, and I saw a totally awesome portfolio that you have to see. And that portfolio was made by Nicholas. Now, you can see how on his homepage, the logo at the top has a rollover function, which is really neat. But also the interface cleanly slides down over the background image, which is something I really do like a whole lot. Now also, each of his project thumbnails is spread across the entire screen, and it actually fills up the color when it's rolled over. But if we head into one project, you will see that he has kept the style and the layout the same throughout the entire portfolio. And there's even the possibility to embed videos directly into your portfolio. Now, I personally think this portfolio is really stunning, and this is the kind of thing that you can technically make using Adobe Portfolio. So very briefly, what are the key aspects of Adobe Portfolio? Well, firstly, you can link a custom domain name to the website, and you also have the ability to link your site to Behance, so you can share the work between the two platforms really, really easily. The design's very responsive, and that's all achieved with no knowledge or experience of coding required. Now, I personally don't do any kind of coding because I never learned that skill, so it's really useful for me. But there's also many, many themes to choose from, and it should be noted that you can actually make multiple websites from just one Creative Cloud account. So let's dive into how to actually set up a website using Adobe Portfolio. Now, when you log in, by default, you will have your Behance account linked. So Adobe is going to import your Behance projects onto this website. Now, I've personally abandoned my Behance account many years ago because I do in fact have my own Folio website. So these are some of my old projects that Adobe has picked up and transferred. But yeah, just as an example to show you guys today, I've placed this Apple MacBook image for my background. And I'm using a theme called Marta, in case you want to know. To make adjustments to specific areas, just click the blue icon here, and then enter into the settings. This is where you can change the background image, and obviously if I was going to change it, I'd just hit the remove image option. You then have the layout options for your image, and also the overlay color and opacity. I really do like the overlay option because it looks really neat and also sleek on the homepage itself. All of your edits are in real time, so you can see your adjustments as you go with the portfolio creation. And then here you can adjust the layout for the header text, as well as the font and the style too. So as you can see, the design is very responsive and neat when you scroll down over the homepage. This is built into the theme that I chose, but do have a look over the themes when you sign in. So over here on the left is the toolbar, and this section allows you to manage your content below the homepage section. Now I can drag and rearrange the order of my projects, which were imported from Behance. And speaking of Behance, this is where you can activate or deactivate the setting for linking your website to Behance. If you do turn it off, however, all of the projects will disappear from your website. And if you want to simply start from scratch on this website, you might want to do that. So obviously the blue icon here is where you can add a new project into your portfolio. There are quite a lot of settings that you probably should take a look at yourself, but to name a few, you can track your website's analytics, such as traffic, sources, and volumes, and that's by linking your website to Google. The use of meta tags is really helpful in boosting your website's search optimization, And that is something you really want to address if you want your website ranking on Google search. So you can try and rank it for things like graphic design or logo design. Now below here, you have some things like the thumbnail for your social media sharing and a few other back-end site settings too. So now going back to my projects below, if you again click the blue icon, you can edit the layouts of your projects by adjusting the margins here. You can also dictate how many projects are in a single row, and also you can change the alignment and stuff too. However, importantly for the overall look and style of your website, you might want to edit the rollover settings. This is how each thumbnail is going to appear when a user hovers their cursor over a specific item. So just as an example, I can shift to a purple from a red overlay. And also, as we saw earlier, you can even just have your thumbnails black and white, and then when someone rolls over them with a cursor, they are filled with color. Another recent feature from Adobe is that they provide you with a domain name, but also now they've linked up with Namecheap, so you can buy one from there, or you can simply use one you've already purchased somewhere else. But just a quick tip, if you can, I recommend securing the .com version of your domain, because that's going to rank a lot easier in Google search terms. And you can check out places like Namecheap or Dynadot, because these are really two good domain registrars that I personally use myself. So yeah, there is today's video, and I'm still getting submissions for the portfolio critique. That is going to come Friday, so do stay tuned for that video, because there are some really interesting and some really awesome portfolios you guys have sent to me. Also, if you want to keep boosting your skills as a graphic designer, do remember to subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. And if you have already subscribed, do make sure to turn on those notifications by clicking that bell icon. But yeah, I'm Tom Satori, and I hope you have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.